Hello and welcome you once again in this new session of history. Today we are going to start with your new chapter, that is lesson number 6, the Vijayanagar and Bhamani kingdoms. Vijayanagar and Bhamani kingdoms are the dynasty that rose in a Deccan cities, and these two kingdoms, Vijayanagar and Bhamani kingdoms, emerged as one of the powerful kingdom of Deccan. As we have learned in our last chapter, in the last session, that there was the dynasty that ruled in the Delhi Sultanate for about 3 centuries. In the meantime, 2 dynasties also emerged in Deccan, and these 2 dynasties were the Vijayanagar and Bhamani kingdoms. Now, let's start with the Vijayanagar kingdom. There were 2 brothers, one name was Harihara I and Bukarao I. They founded the Hindu religions of Vijayanagar on the bank of river Tungabhadra. Tungabhadra was the river where Harihara I and Bukarao I, they were the 2 brothers, they founded the Hindu religion kingdom in Vijayanagar. Their dynasty was known as a Sangama dynasty. The 2 brothers expanded their small kingdoms by capturing the neighboring territories, and they made their capital Vijayanagar. Vijayanagar kingdom was also known as Vijayanagar. The successive rulers greatly expanded after their death. Their successors, they expanded the Vijayanagar kingdom, and at one time the kingdom covered the whole of the South India from river Tungabhadra to the southmost tip of India. The Vijayanagar kingdom became an important center of Hindu culture, and it is believed that it lasted for about 230 years and saw the rule of 16 kings under 3 dynasties. So in the Vijayanagar, there were the 16 kings ruled for 213 years, and these 230 years they saw 3 dynasties. And dynasties were Sangama dynasty, Saluva dynasty, and Tuluva dynasty. Sangama dynasty emerged from 1336 AD to 1485 AD. Saluva dynasty from 1485 AD to 1505 AD. And Tuluva dynasty from 1505 AD to 1565 AD. Now we will read about the Krishna Deva Raya. He was one of the greatest ruler of Vijayanagar. During his reign, Vijayanagar emerged as a powerful and prosperous kingdom. We know about the reign of Krishna Deva Raya from the account of Portuguese traveler Domingo Pais and a Persian traveler Abdul Razzaq. So 2 famous travelers came, one from Portuguese, his name was Domingo Pais, and another was the Persian. He came from Persia, his name was Abdul Razzaq. They wrote about the Krishna Deva Raya, a great king of Vijayanagar. Krishna Deva Raya belonged to a Tuluva dynasty, ruled for 21 years from 1509 to 1530 AD. He was a great general, he was a good administrator. Krishna Deva Raya, he also occupied a unique place among the rulers of South India. He was a very good in his administration. He had become a legend. Even children and illiterate villagers called him a recall for his exploits. He was such a good general. But later on, after 230 years, there was a decline in Vijayanagar. Krishna Deva Raya, he died in 1530 AD. His successors proved incompetent. They were not as good as Krishna Deva Raya, and later on, they could not withstand and continue the attack by the five small kingdoms that once comprised the Bhavani kingdom. In the Battle of Talaikota in 1565, Krishna Deva Raya, when he died in 1530, his competitors, who was their successors, they lost all the battle, especially the five cities they fought against their successors of the Krishna Deva Raya. In the Battle of Talaikota in 1565 AD, the Vijayanagar rulers Rama Raya faced the combined attack of the five Bhamani kingdoms and suffered a crushing defeat. And after this defeat, Vijayanagar kingdom was declined, and by the end of the 17th century, it was being seized. The administration of the Vijayanagar kingdom was headed by the administrator. His word was the law, and the administrator was king himself. King also constituted a council of ministers that assisted him in running of the all the administration. Vijayanagar kingdom was divided into six provinces, and these provinces were called rajyas or mandalams, and the provinces were divided into nadus, that means district, and each nadu was consisted with the gram, or you can say villages, and each province was headed by the governor. So the Vijayanagar kingdom was divided into the six provinces, which were called rajya or mandalams, and the provinces were divided into nadus, that means district, and each nadus was consisted with the gram or village, and each of these province was headed by the governor. So governor was the head of these provinces. A notable feature of the Vijayanagar administration was the administrative post gradually become hereditary. Their economic condition was very good, as we have known about from the foreign travelers. As you have heard before, the foreign travelers like Domingo Pius, Abdul Razak, they wrote in their book that the land tax was levied according to the fertility of the land. It varied from 1/3 to 1/6 of the produce, and the state took steps to improve the irrigation. Their social religions, the society of the Vijayanagar kingdom was conservative. They followed the caste system of the Vedic age, and the Brahmin was the class wielded a great influence on the masses. In their period, women were generally not free to participate in any political or social activity. Social practices like child marriage, polygamy and sati were very common during that time. And the Vijayanagar kingdom is described as the Hindu kingdom. However, its rulers were secular in their outlook. They did not discriminate between their subjects on the basic religion. Especially the Muslims were also employed in both army and administrative. Though Vijayanagar was a Hindu religion country, but they believe in the secularism, and most of their army and administrative officers were Muslim too. Art and architectures in the Vijayanagar ruler, they promote languages like Sanskrit, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Krishnadevaraya's reign is considered as the golden period of the development. He himself penned a library like Amuktam Malayada in Telugu, Usha Parinam in Sanskrit. Krishnadevaraya gave a prominent place to 8 great poets in his court. There were the 8 poets in his court, and these 8 poets were called Ashtadiggaj. They were known as Ashtadiggaj. Of them, Alasi Peddana is considered the father of Telugu poetry. He wrote Manu Charitra. So there were 8 poets. They got place in Krishnadevaraya's court, and they were known as Ashtadiggajas. And among them, Alasani Peddana, he was known as the father of Telugu poetry. He wrote Manu Charitra. Now, Vijayanagar kingdoms used gold, silver, and copper coins bearing their names. Some coins also had images of various gods, including Krishna and Venkateshwara. The coins had Kannada and Telugu inscription. The reign of Krishnadevaraya not only marked a climax in a territorial expansion of the Vijayanagar Empire, but also a remarkable development in the art and architecture. He was very much believed in art and architecture also. You see this temple like Vithalakshmi Temple at Hampi. It is one of the finest example of Vijayanagar style of architecture. Then the famous Hazara Temple, it was built during the reign of Krishnadevaraya, is perfect specimen of Hindu temple. The Vithal Swami Temple. The temple was dedicated to Lord Vishnu. Its constructed was started by Krishnadevaraya in 1513 AD. The temple is situated in Hampi near Hospet in Karnataka. The temples have 3 gopurams, and the temple complex has many buildings. The temples also has a Kalyan Mandap and an Aman Shrine. The Aman Shrine is dedicated to the consort of the chief deity Vitthala. And the Kalyan Mandap was open pillared hall with raised platform. The temple has an open pavilion with 56 beautifully carved pillars. There is a rath made of single block of granite crept in the courtyard. You can see this. This is a Hazara temple, and this is the rath, which is made of a single block of granite. It is kept here in this temple. The ruins of Hampi, located near Bengaluru in Karnataka, stand as a proof of the architectural excellence of Vijayanagar Kingdom. Hampi, now a UNESCO World Heritage. Hampi is the UNESCO's World Heritage Site. The part of the capital of kingdom, the architectural wonder of Hampi include the Vithal Swami Temple, the Lotus Mahal, and the Hazara Temple and Stone Chariot. So that's all for today's session. We will once again continue this session with the Bhamani Kingdom in our next session. Till then, have a nice day and take care of your health.